This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Current transformers and equivalent circuit model. Part 1A, the excitation impedance. In Part 1A of this series, we shall explain the important parameters of a current transformer when it comes to its equivalent circuit model, and we'll go through this in much greater detail. The equivalent circuit model and its important parameters were briefly discussed in the previous video series called The Brief Introduction to Current Transformers and Its Applications. Please follow the link in the description section below. If you haven't watched this already, we recommend that you watch it and view it before going through this particular tutorial. It sets a very good foundation, and it helps to describe some of the concepts that are shown in this tutorial. Let us now review the simplified equivalent circuit model of a current transformer in detail and discuss each parameter to great extent. Now we shall start with the excitation impedance and the excitation current, which is critical for analyzing the overall behavior of a current transformer. So, this equivalent circuit model of a CT is drawn as you can see on the screen. There is an excitation impedance which we will represent by ZE. It tells us about the magnetization behavior of the CT core. And this ZE branch, or the ZE value, or the excitation branch, it is non-linear in nature, which means that this impedance changes as the CT saturates, and it results in a varying secondary excitation voltage VE, as well as the varying excitation branch current IE. So ZE is equal to VE over IE, and ZE is a nonlinear value. And we'll go over this in much more detail later in this tutorial. Now we also have a primary current IP that flows through the primary winding of a current transformer. This IP value produces a total secondary current on the secondary side of the winding, and in mathematical terms we can represent this parameter using the following equation. IST is equal to IE plus IS, where IE is the excitation current and IS is the secondary current flowing through the winding and flowing to the secondary CT burden. The total secondary current, as shown by IST, is equal to the secondary current only when IE is equal to zero. Now, what does that mean? What we're trying to say here is that if we model an ideal current transformer where there is no error or there is no saturation, where the primary current is equal to the secondary current, in this case we are saying that IE is zero and IST is equal to IS. IE is zero, or it's a negligible value. So practically speaking, IE, the impedance flowing through the magnetization branch, cannot equal zero because it is responsible for producing the magnetizing current in a current transformer, and that is required for it to operate in a practical sense. But it can be minimized by increasing the value of the excitation impedance. So CT designers can reduce the magnetization current IE, and by increasing the excitation impedance ZE, and therefore reduce the overall error or overall chances of the CT becoming saturated. Now the value of ZE, that is inversely proportional to the excitation current. So if ZE is high, then the excitation current will be low. And if ZE is low, then the excitation current will be high. The excitation current is also directly proportional to the CT error. Therefore, the greater the excitation current, the greater the CT error. Now, how will we represent this mathematically? Well, that is, it's very simple. ZE is proportional to 1 over IE. So this is an inverse proportional relationship. If one goes up, the other goes down, and vice versa. And IE, the excitation current, is directly proportional to the CT error. So if one goes up, the other goes up, and one goes down, the other goes down with it. So keep in mind that the protection class and metering class current transformer should be designed so that ZE is a high value. That is required to minimize the total amount of CT error. And if the value of ZE is high, the excitation current flowing through the magnetization branch will be negligible, will be very small, and we won't really see that much error or that much saturation in a CT. This way, the excitation current will be low, and so will the CT error produced by the current transformer. Now, this example, this entire series, are derived from SEL's article called Beyond the Knee Point. It's a practical guide to CT saturations. So rest assured, these are good and accurate examples. If mistakes are found, they will be described in great detail at generalpack.com. In part 1b, we'll go over the CT excitation current and the excitation curve in more detail. Now, we hope this topic and series is enjoyable and enlightening for students and professionals. If you find this content useful, please consider subscribing to generalpack.com and supporting us through patreon.com/generalpack. We make power systems intuitive. Thank you.